So, you want to get your app into the hands of millions, right? Well, before you can do that, you've got to get past Apple's front door. Today, we're breaking down the exact key you need for that door, setting up your official Apple developer account. Let's get right into it.
Okay, picture this. You've spent weeks, maybe months, pouring your heart and soul into building an amazing app. The design is slick, the code is clean, it's all tested, but now what? What's that next step to get it from your machine onto millions of iPhones? That answer starts with one really crucial step.
You know, it's easy to look at this as just boring paperwork, another administrative hurdle to jump through. But it's so, so much more than that. This account, it's the official gateway. It's the key that unlocks Apple's entire world for you. All the powerful developer tools, the user analytics, and of course, the App Store itself. All right. Before we even think about the official enrollment, we need to lay a little bit of groundwork. There are two super quick but absolutely non-negotiable things we have to take care of first.
First up, you're going to need an Apple ID. Now, if you have an iPhone or a Mac, you're already set. But the really critical part here is enabling two-factor authentication, or 2FA. And let me be perfectly clear, this isn't a suggestion, it's a mandatory security layer that Apple requires for every single developer. No exceptions.
And honestly, there's a really good reason for this. Just think about it for a second. Your developer account is going to hold your app, your revenue, and maybe even some sensitive user data. Securing it from day one is absolutely paramount, and Apple enforces this to protect both you and your future users. Okay, with that foundation all set, you're ready to make what is probably the single most important decision in this whole process, choosing what kind of account you're going to create. This right here is the first major fork in the road, and the choice you make is going to determine how your app actually looks on the App Store and how you manage everything behind the scenes. So let's break down the two paths you can take. The choice really just boils down to this. Are you a solo creator or are you a company? If you choose individual, your own personal name will be listed as the publisher on the App Store. It's simple, it's direct. But if you're a registered business, choosing organization lets you use your company's name and, this is a big one, it lets you grant access to other team members. The only extra hoop you'll have to jump through for an organization account is getting something called a DUNS number.
So, what on earth is a DUNS number? Yeah, it sounds a little intimidating, but don't worry, it's pretty straightforward. Just think of it like a universal serial number for businesses. Apple uses it to verify that your organization is a real, legitimate legal entity. And the best part? If you don't have one, Apple actually helps you get one for free during the enrollment process.
Once you've picked your account type, you're in the home stretch. Now it's just time to handle the final administrative stuff, the verification and the payment.
This part is pretty straightforward, but you have to be detail-oriented. You'll fill out your profile, add your contact info, and of course, accept that big old developer program license agreement. A little word of advice here. Be meticulous. I mean it. Even a tiny typo that doesn't match your legal documents can cause some serious delays. So please double check everything.
And speaking of delays, it's really important to set your expectations right. If you're enrolling as an individual, verification is usually almost instant. But for an organization, Apple needs some time to cross-reference your legal status and that DUNS number. You should expect this to take about 1 to 2 business days, so make sure you factor that into your launch timeline.
And now for the final step, the price tag. The Apple Developer Program membership is a flat fee of $99 a year. The way I see it, this is your ticket to the show. It's what gets you in the door, giving you the ability to publish on the App Store and access to Apple's entire suite of developer tools.
Now, it's super important to remember this isn't a one-time fee, it's a yearly subscription. If your membership lapses, your apps will actually be removed from the App Store.
Yeah.
To avoid that total nightmare scenario, I highly, highly recommend just enabling the automatic renewal option when you check out.
Once your payment is processed, you're pretty much there. Just keep a close eye on your inbox for the official welcome email from Apple. It usually shows up within 24 hours. And that email is the confirmation you've been waiting for. Your account is officially active. So you've got that welcome email, which means you've officially crossed the finish line. All the paperwork is done, and now you get to access the really fun part, your mission control for the App Store.
Congratulations, you are now an official Apple developer. This unlocks access to your new best friend, App Store Connect. This is the central hub, the command center for your app. It's where you'll upload your app builds, create your store listing, track all your downloads and revenue, respond to user reviews. It's where everything happens.
So before you rush to hit that upload button, let's do a quick final pre-flight check. You've got your developer account? Check. You've got your tested app build? Check. You'll also need all your App Store assets ready to go. Your icon, your screenshots, your description. But the most important item on this list, and trust me, the one that trips up most new developers, is the last one. Making sure you've actually read and followed Apple's official App Store review guidelines. Seriously, don't skip that step.
And there you have it. You've navigated the whole process and cleared the first major hurdle on the path from just an idea to a global launch. The gateway is wide open. The tools are right there in your hands. So now, the only question left is the most exciting one of all. What are you going to create?